Hi, I'm Bill Kleitz. The material that I'll be covering in this podcast is out of my Digital Electronics 9th Edition textbook. I hope you find it useful.
Hi, this is Professor Kleitz, and in this section I want to talk about switches in electric circuits. We'll start out with the basic switches, and then we'll move into using relays for switching our highs and lows in digital format. I can't stress enough, if you want a review of basic electricity, check out Appendix F. Go through the basic calculations using Ohm's law and work our way up through the voltage divider law, which will be very useful when we look at relays and transistors coming up soon. Okay, the basic switch has practically perfect characteristics. When it's open, it looks like infinity ohms. So in other words, no current could pass from A through to B. And when it's closed, it's a perfect short, 0 ohms if you were measuring with an ohm meter, and current would easily pass through from A to B. So if we use a switch in that way, this is actually a single pole double throw. You can throw it up or down. When it's thrown in the up position, and if you had a 5 volt power supply or a battery, you would feel 5 volts at the output, which is known as a 1. With the switch in the low position, it would be like a 0 because it's connected directly to ground. So if you're out here looking in, you would see a low. If you're out here looking in, you'd see a high. So an electromechanical relay has contacts just like a manual switch, but is controlled by an external voltage instead of being operated manually. They're often used to deliver high-low levels to a real high power load, like a high wattage lamp or a motor, or anything that's drawing a lot of current. You want to use a relay because the contacts can handle large amperage. A relay's operation is quite simple. The coil creates an electromagnetic field when you apply a voltage on the C1, C2 terminals. And so if you apply, in this case, a 5 volt signal or a 5 volt voltage to this, current will flow through the coil, creating a magnetic attraction. The contacts will be drawn down toward the coil, and as you can see in this illustration, if the contacts are pulled down, the lower contacts pulled down, this creates an open circuit between X1, X2. These are called normally closed contacts because they're normally closed before you energize the coil. In figure B, the contacts are normally open. When you energize the coil, the top contact comes down and makes a contact between X1 and X2, creating 0 ohms and allowing current to flow through the contacts back out to X2. And I've got photographs of relays. This is an integrated circuit type relay. There are actual moving contacts inside of here. I don't have the pin layout right here in front of me, but you can look this up, the MagnaCraft W107, and it's called a DIP1, meaning dual inline package. And two of these are the coil contacts, and two of them are normally closed contacts, normally open contacts. A larger physical relay is shown here, and you can see the coil of wire, and when you energize that, this section on the top actually comes down and the contactors connect to the bottom, which would have been the normally open contacts, and when you release the coil, this spring right here pulls this back up and there's contact with the top, which are the normally closed contacts. So it's important for us to understand the schematic diagram for any of these circuits. In the case of the relay, here's the C1, C2 coil, and we've got a switch. When we close the switch, we're applying 5 volts to the coil, and these contacts, which are normally closed, that's what the slash means. It's normally closed before it's energized. When you energize by closing the switch, these go to its opposite state, which means they open. When X1, X2 open, this 12 volt supply in the external circuitry is going to allow current to flow down through the 5K and through the second 5K, because if this is open, the current will flow down this way. While it was closed, the current would have come down here and over to ground. So if you've got a 5K and a 5K, from Appendix F we know voltage divider law, this will give us 5 volts at the output. So the bottom line here is, with the switch open, The coil is not energized, the contacts will be closed. The output voltage of VL will be zero because this is a direct short to ground. When we close SW, that energizes the coil. It makes the contacts go to their opposite state, which is open. And now the current will flow through a voltage divider, 5K, 5K, giving us half the voltage out, which would be 6. Now, the normally open contacts, when you close the switch, they close. So you get the exact opposite effect at Vout2. And of course, it's important to analyze a relay in an external circuit by looking at the timing diagram for it. So in figure 2-16, we're going to use a clock oscillator to produce 0505 pulses to the coil. Now the coil generally will have a reverse bias diode across. We'll look at diodes in a little bit later in the chapter. And basically, this is because when you de-energize the coil, it tends to want a spark from its ends, and the diode will dissipate that charge so that you don't get sparking taking place in the coil. But back to the clock oscillator. As this clock oscillator goes high, it energizes the coil. When the clock oscillator goes low, it de-energizes it. These are normally open contacts. When the coil is energized, they close. When it's de-energized, it's open. We've got a 10-volt power supply with two equal resistors, meaning the Vout is going to oscillate between 5 volts and 0. 5 volts and 0. Now, to analyze this, we look at the CP waveform. While it's low, the coil's not energized. While it's high, the coil is energized. Now, as I said before, if the coil's not energized, the contacts will be open. If the contacts are open, the output is 5. So what you do is, while this is low, draw a line for the 5 volts at the output, VL3. When the coil is energized, the contacts are closed, and as I said before, if they're closed, you have a direct connection right to the ground terminal. If you're out here looking in, what do you see? You see a direct wire right down to ground. That means 0. That's why I drew this low right here. So while it's energized, this is low. When it's de-energized, the output's 5. When it's energized, the output's low, and it just repeats over and over again. So you'll be required to draw these timing waveforms for both the normally open and the normally closed contacts. Of course, if you had normally closed contacts, this waveform would be inverted from what you're looking at right here. So you need to study all the examples coming up now in the textbook. Example 7 shows a clock oscillator, and I've put the relay contacts in series with a resistor. This is going to give us an entirely different result. When the coil is energized, these contacts close. That puts Vout1 directly to ground. That'll be 0. And so that's why when this is high, this output is 0. On the other hand, when the clock oscillator has got a 0 on it, the relay is not energized, these are open. Now, what happens to Vout1? With this open circuit down here, we have nowhere for the current to flow. It can't flow down. So with no current flow, you have no voltage drop. If you do I times R, you'll have a 0 volt drop across the 1K. So if you've dropped nothing, you start with 5, drop nothing, you still got 5. So this is why, when you look at the waveforms, when you have 0 on the CP line, the coil's not energized, this is open. So if, like I said, if this is open, you're sitting at 5. So when you have an open circuit below the measuring point and you have no current flow, the output will be whatever your power supply is for that circuit. So I don't want to do all the work for you and take all the fun away, but if you look at example 2-8, here's slightly different. I did have the relay down in series with that 6K, but I stuck another 4K out here. So now we have unequal resistors. You have to use a voltage divider law to calculate what's going to happen. And so what you want to do is analyze when this is low, this is an open, what do you have at the output? When this is high, this is a short. R2 is, the contacts are closed or shorted. What do you have at the output? So I want you to do this on your own.